told you. I just bet you'd kill a defenseless man.
Yeah, I'm shaking in my
You son of a bitch! You best hope I never get out of here! Damn you!
You looking to die too? Shut up!
Where's the sport in shooting someone in a cage?
Hello again.
Hello. Oh, hello. How are you, sir? Morgan, Mr. Morgan. I'm sorry, my nerves. I'm not quite the outdoor adventurer I thought. This is God's own country, and I feel I'm in purgatory.
I know the feeling.
No, I hope not.
So what you trying to take some pictures of, huh? Some more greedy coyotes?
No. Wolves.
Wolves? Now you really are trying to get yourself eaten.
Oh, I hope not. I left the meat over there. I thought I'd be safe, given the wind.
Yeah, sure. If you manage to attract the world's least intelligent wolf.
Well, I'll
stay with you a while. If anything comes, I'll protect you as needed.
You are a gentleman.
Now, you don't know me very well.
Well, to me, you're a gentleman.
Willie, I'm worse than the wolves.
You had many dealings with wolves, Mr. Morgan?
Sure.
But you've never been eaten.
Not through lack of trying on their part. A while back, I helped a friend from Howard. Usually they are not great fans of man.
Don't blame them.
Me neither. Hey, shh. Here's one. Looks like we got company.
Yes, yes, there they are. In the tree. Now, don't do anything. I'm going to take a few photographs. Come on. Come on. Hungry boys. Come on. Stay back, stay back. Can't have a man in the frame. They'd think it's staged.
Yeah, sort of is.
Look at them. Magnificent creatures. You provoked them, Mr. Morgan. Help!
They ain't provoked. They're just wolves.
Mr. Morgan, help!
Is that all of them? We might have kept the wolves from the door.
My whole futile existence flashed before my eyes.
Yeah, they can be pretty aggressive.
What a way to... literally a dog's dinner. Still worse things happen at sea?
Do they?
Well, I imagine. Perhaps wolves do better at sea. Are they good swimmers? Well, who knows? You have saved my poor foolish skin once again.
Don't mention it.
Well, I can't begin to repay my debt of gratitude. But no, I am eternally in your debt.
I do, Mr. Mason, I do. You take care now.
And you too, sir.
Well, just checking this equipment, if only my hands weren't shaking quite so much. You're a collector of pelts. I hope only in cases of self-defense. I'll do some time working on the mechanism. Good day to you, sir, and Godspeed. The only trophy I need is a photograph, and I hope it catches on.
Welcome, sir. Come see what I got. Snacks and booze on the back wall there. Razors, soaps, and whatnot to the side. Post office on the far wall. Fella's an idiot, but don't judge me for it. Anything you can't see, just check the catalog. All right, now, let me lay my eyes on it. Say, you don't look so good, partner. You all right?
Thank you for your help.
Welcome. How do you do? Nothing like a fresh start.
Oh, dear. Have you come down with the flu as well, sir?
Flu? No. What are you talking about?
Nothing.
Farewell on your travels.
Nothing. It's just been going around, that's all. Anyway, how can I help you?
It's best to get a move on now.
Hey, move it!
What do you want?
What's your problem?
Sister.
Calderon, Brother Dorkins and I were talking about you just the other day and hoping we would see you again.
How is Brother Dorkins?
Oh, he's quite well. A little frustrated with the workings of our order. He keeps trying to be sent overseas, you know, do something with more challenge, maybe be a missionary. He's a lovely man.
Sure.
And how are you?
Never better.
Are you sure?
I'm quite sure, sister.
You know, a long time ago, I was like you.
I very much doubt that.
Oh, no, I did terrible things, awful things. And I could not stop doing terrible things because I did not believe that goodness existed. And then one day, I saw that love did exist. And ever since then, doing bad things became, well, not impossible, but ridiculous.
I guess I'm just hoping for a dignified exit.
I shall pray for you.
Oh, I'm not a religious man, sister. I'm an outlaw.
Oh, what fun. Religion is just a word. Hearts are rarely pure, but equally they are rarely impure either.
Well, that's an interesting way of putting it.
To me, God is people and people are God, so we must all do what we can. These people are starving. Go find them some food. Don't worry so much about your heart. The actions will lead, and the heart follows. I'll still think of you in very nasty terms, as you wish. Were you able to bring me, Mr. Morgan? I have four very hungry mouths to feed.
Some? Well, not enough for four, I don't reckon.
Please try to get some more. These children are desperate for a good meal. And bless you again for trying. No time like the present, Mr. Morgan.
Hey, mister.
Morning.
You know what, sister? I've got some money on me right now. You can buy some food with this.
Oh, you're so wonderful, Mr. Morgan.
No, that ain't true.
I meant wonderful, but so very frightening. Exactly.
Yep. Fine morning.
Consider your good deed done for the day. I will, sir.
What's dogging you?
There, boy.
What's your issue?
Yeah, good boy.
I'm looking for Gavin. Move!
Looking for trouble?
Yeah. Something the matter?
Are you looking to make me angry?
This horse got worms or something. Damn, it's skinny. If you want me to keep that overnight, there's room in the stable.
Fine. Don't you worry about me.
Oh, it's you.
I got his letter.
Mr. Arthur.
Sir?
Education is the most wonderful thing. It'll raise us higher and higher. Make civics and ethics less a work of a dirty-minded pragmatist like me. And the calling of higher, better men.
Hear, hear.
Without it, we are savages. But with learning, why, in 50 years, man will put down his guns and start living a life of relentless purity.
Hear, hear.
But the rich can be so very self-absorbed.
How can I help?
You can't.
We need all our strengths. That's the point. We've gone over this.
Violence is never right.
I agree with you. But it's not violence. It's the mere threat of violence.
Against whom?
Oh. Against Hector Fellow's worst nature. To convince him to make good on his promise to help finance the library.
Who is he and where do I find him?
He's a newspaper man. And he's
leaving town on a coach, heading to his country estate because he doesn't like your heavy-handed approach.
Well, he certainly won't like my heavy-handed approach.
Thank you, Mr. Arthur.
You'll spot him on the road through the bayou. He has a red coach. So we are clear. I do not approve of this behavior.
Getting in. When I get in, you carry on.
What the hell do you want?
Mr. Fellows, ain't it? Charity, sir. And an appeal to your better nature.
This is most impudent.
Oh, no, it's not most impudent. Trust me, buddy. I can get a whole lot more impudent. But this is a good cause for a wealthy man such as yourself. The chance to add some dignity to all that wealth.
Dignity?
By helping to finance a library in town. Think of the prestige, sir.
Oh, get out of my carriage.
But the mayor.
The mayor? The mayor is a crook.
Me too. And I'm a real crook.
I will not be bullied by you, sir. Get out of here.
I'd like to finance the library for the common good. Ah! I didn't hear you. Ah! What was that?
Ah! Please! All right!
There. You see? That wasn't difficult. You know, they say it's better to give than to receive. Certainly, in the case of a beating, I know that's true. Now, the mayor awaits your check, sir. Been a pleasure. There's a good man in there. Let him live a little more. Driver, hold up. As you were. Drive on. Let's go, boy. Yep.
Yeah. Arthur, it's you. Come in.
Where's what's his name?
Jean-Marc, he's a little histrionic. I'm worried that he's going to open his mouth and say things that aren't true to those vulgar Puritans at the newspaper. Well, perhaps true, but not the whole truth. Look at these beautiful books. This is magnificent. We'll bring this city back to life if it kills me, and it probably shall.
Yes.
I have two copies of this book. This is an old field guide. Might be of some interest to you, maybe not. But please have it. It's worth quite a bit.
Thank you.
My pleasure. Listen, Mr. Arthur, I'm sorry to ask this of you. You've done so much, but...
But what?
Jean-Marc. I'm afraid he's going to open his mouth and say things.
How do you mean?
Saying nasty things about the work that we have done together, for example.
Is that my business?
Oh, no, no. Of course not. He also found out some unsettling news about you. It's all scurrilous lies, of course. But...
What sort of news?
Oh, I do not talk about idle gossip. Please, I'm a public servant, and we are friends.
Where do I find him?
Well, he does live over on Rue de Zachary.
Rue de Zachary.
Thank you, Arthur.
Why you wanna go and say those awful things about me, buddy? It's best not to make a big drama of things. Come on, let's go see your boss. This is gonna hurt, but it's for the best.
bring him around the back.
Now, don't get thoughts above your station.
Oh, Jean-Marc, I've missed you. I've missed you. What silly, silly man we have been.
Yeah, he had a fall. He might be a little woozy.
Oh, the poor boy. Jean-Marc, can you hear me?
Where am I? Le Mieux? What have you done?
Oh, you had an accident, Jean-Marc. Thank the Lord, our friend was there to find you.
Really? I don't remember so well.
No, Jean-Marc. We had...
Here. My brother. Jean-Marc. Well, we've been so... I promised to change.
I know.
What a silly, silly misunderstanding. You see, the problem is principles will destroy us all.
Sure. As long as you two are friends again.
Yes. And you say you've changed, so we will run the city like men of honor, like you said.
Of course. We will strive to improve the city's moral backbone by any means available to us.
Within reason, yes.
Yes. Within my reason. Because I am the mayor, Jean-Marc. And I will save you from yourself. Because it's better to get something done than nothing at all, like you said.
Utterly corrupted, Lemieux. You've not changed at all. I've been supplanted in your esteem by a wanted murderer. You shame me.
No, sir. You shame me with your vain naivete. Oh. How I long for the luxury to have principles such as you. But I must actually do things.
I see now. You're lost to reason.
Yeah. And I see now that you're a horrible little wretch and a sinner yourself. Your sin is deluded vanity. Now, sir, I am afraid that you must kill him. I will pay you handsomely. And Jean-Marc, I will miss you. I really shall.
Kill him.
It must be so. Please.
You're not really going to kill me, are you?
Thought I might.
But all I did was love too much.
Love?
My duty.
Yeah, but you're running your
I'll
mouth
leave you out
about
of it.
Me, buddy. And him.
He'll betray you, just like he's betrayed me. Lemieux is a foul rat, but I'm a man of my word. Let me live, and I'll destroy him. And I'll make sure you're left well alone. Come on, please. Please, come on. You wouldn't shoot a sad little man, would you?
I might be a brute, but I'm not a paid killer. Get out of here. Don't mention me, boy.
I give you my word.
Okay, boy. Let's go.
Happy to assist you in a moment. Can I be of service? Oh dear. Have you come down with the flu as well, sir?
Flu? No. What are you talking about?
Nothing. It's just been going around, that's all. Traveling mercies to you.